Hello everybody, it's me again with the review of the Force Equestria Girls movie. First of all, I saw that Aramis flooded my comment section. I didn't read them, so sorry if I repeat anything mentioned there. Secondly, if you want to watch my band reaction, follow this card on the corner, then come back here. There will be a lot to talk about, so I wouldn't be surprised if this video would be longer than 30 minutes, so to keep everything straight, I will be going by chronological order and put the timestamps in the closed captions. So if you didn't do that yet, I suggest you to enable it. It's down here somewhere. Now, that's the introductions are done. Let's jump into the review, going after every single little. Not true. Starting in Twilight's room. This is actually the first time we see her room, as in the friendship games we only saw her research lab in the Crystal Pub. And I have to say, I would happily live in that room. Spacious, nicely furnished, organized. Well, we are talking about Twilight here. And not to mention, she was using double monitors just like I do. You can't see it, but I have double monitors right here. But it seems she lives alone with Spike, probably moved from her family just like Pony Twilight. I'm sure her research project and scholarships are more than enough to pay the rent of an attic room. But when I first watched the movie, I didn't hear that Rainbow was shouting that the bus is leaving in 10 minutes. 10 minutes? Nobody is capable of packing for camp and catch the bus in that small time. Why did they wait for this long if it's not like Twilight? To be late, they would go get her at the first late minute. Not 10 minutes before the bus leaves. And at this phrase, at 1:20, I also have to point out that Spike is actually capable of opening the door, which has the lock over the handle on both sides. My. And Twilight has an aquarium with no fishes inside and a lot of trophies and medals, even though she mentioned she hates competitions. It seems the friendship games weren't the first that Principal Grinch forced Twilight to participate in. It was not the first time. It was all to withhold the school's reputation. But yeah, she is still good. And I'm pretty sure she has more science projects in that small fridge under the microscope than actual food. I don't know if it's just me, but I like the fact that not all of them are wearing skirts here. The girls, they are going for camping. I felt like the skirts really were really first in the first three movies. That's for sure. But that is the most noise cancelling pillow I have ever seen. Because that is not a silent clock. No. Maybe Pinky did hear the alarm, as she was much closer than the camera to it. But the campus leaves at 6:14. That is quite an odd time. Why not 6 or 7 o'clock straight? Well, we will help you pack. Everyone chose one thing to throw in. Let's see what we have here. A flashlight from Sunset. Makes sense. A muffin from Pinky. You can eat it. A picture of herself from Rainbow. A stuffed llama door from Photoshy. Again, not really useful. Spike's favorite toy. And the mini dress from Rarity. To camping. So the only useful things are coming from Sunset and maybe Spike. And maybe Pinky. Wait, they let Spike come to a camp? When I was camping, there were the no pets allowed thing put out in at the entrance. But, oh well, but convenience. Spike has to be in the movie. And I think, yeah, I think this spot just happened, just before, just happened, okay, sorry, I'm not gonna restart the whole recording, I'm just gonna think a bit. Yeah, this part happened in the Viking world, this part before Midnight Sparkle appeared. This really happened. And there are some cases of falling asleep where you forget that what happened because of the exhaustion and you don't remember when the dream started. I think it is, this is the case here as well, because she got on the bus. But now we know that this part is definitely a dream. At least I know. Because for once, Twilight and Midnight Sparkle are one being. They cannot be separated. Just like we have here. Though nobody else calls her that later in the movie except Sunset, who learns the name from Twilight. So I guess this is just a name she unconsciously gave her. Not everybody else calls her that. And sadly, this first Luna is not capable of dreamwalking, so she has to fight on her own with the nightmare. But back in the Viking world, on the bus we have a lot more to take in, like Bonbon and Reiner are obviously sitting together as best friends. But what is Lyra doing? Meditating? Even Bombo is looking at her strange, while she murmurs something and holds her hands somewhere like this. Is she a part of the Illuminati or, or what? But as I mentioned at the movie, I liked how Celestia and Luna are wearing her scout uniforms and badges, even though they probably had to got new clothes since the scout days. I also, we can point out that Flash is the only student that is sitting alone in the front of the bus. Even though he is the cool guy in the class with the guitar, no one chose to sit near him, even though he sat in the front, probably earlier than everyone else. Even Trixie has many more people to speak with than him. And that is quite something to say. And we are running into the intro. With one of the best intro songs in my opinion, with its camping, Celtic vibes in it. But I have to say the visuals remind me of two things. One, the bus rolling down the road. It is basically, I'm going down to South Park, gonna have myself a time. Yep, it's basically the same. And sorry for that. And two, the forest reminds me of Gravity Falls. Really much. One of my favorite shows. Favorite Disney shows. But let's talk about Spike, who can still talk after all things happened. And this is the first time we hear him talk at this. I kind of forgot that this Spike was always a dog and have tendencies of a dog would do, like chasing scratch or anything smaller than them moving, basically. They did a great job on reminding us that this is not the same useless Spike, even though our Spike did save them from the unlocked door in Rainbow Frogs. But still, moving on, thanks to the PPOV episode, we know what Pinky thinks of Reti and her tendencies to bring too much stuff with her. Well, this is still nothing to her, but looking at the 10 sizes later on, I feel sorry for Pinky, as there will be literally no space left in it after Reti pulls all her stuff in. And I am getting used to the no offense joke. As you could hear, I even finished it for them. Unlike Twilight, who seems to have stopped experimenting with magic since she saw its dangerous side effects. Well, I can't blame her. I don't like being reminded of my past mishaps either, even if they meant it as a joke. But, as I mentioned, Drissa seems to get well with others now, talking with Octavia, seeming to have fun together, while on the other hand we have the strange encounter between Skytry and Flash, that literally sounded really badly, whom I have nothing against, and kind of feel sorry for him. It does feel like as if Twilight had a twin sister, so she has to be sure not to mix the two together, but he could at least try to know her better, not just drop a meme and leave. Cool story, bro. Even Saitai knows how awkward this was to everyone around. And here a warning. I was listening to this movie on a high volume at first, and this was really, really not necessary. Please, never do that again. That stupid sound. Also, hearing the word red made me think of a totally different personality than Daisy's. I just couldn't see that character coming out with that. And about the quarry, you can go there, but the word limit is non-existent in the word in the Wonder Quotes dictionary. And I'm not gonna stop the recording because of that. I'm just gonna leave TeamSpeak just now. Sorry. Where was I? Oh yeah, at the limit. If something was forbidden, we can be sure that something is happening there and our main characters will find out what it is. But speaking about this, let's just talk about the Mark Biceps. He might look scary, but he's actually a very nice guy. Thinking about family and Arthurscraft is one of the best ideas to do in the camp. We can say never judge a book from its cover. But a fashion show? I know. Rarity is rarity, but I'm a bit edgy here, or I can just quote Professor Oak in the Pokemon games. There is a time and place to do everything, and this is not one of that. You can't use a bicycle in the room. But you say you design everything. What if anybody else wants to show off their designs? It's probably not gonna happen, but you closed off everybody else from the phone with the I'm gonna design everything. While they were planning camera activities, Twy was actually literally staring at Timber for quite a time. And I can see why she got embarrassed when their eyes met. At least it wasn't like, oh, I got bumped into you and had to hold her hand to get her up. Kinda interaction. No, it was actually, it's okay, it happens all the time. When you watch something, okay, she looks alright. But when she turns back and sees that you are looking at her, it's just kinda embarrassing. Unless you go there. But still, as I said, I had no problem with Flash, and I still don't have it. But I consented to this relationship more. Even though Timber is really cheesy, he's doing something to get Saitai's attention. Their little flirting sessions make this okay in my book. Even if they are cheesy. And I like how Daisy planned forward. She already checked the weather, as we saw in her pamphlets, asked every student what they would like to do, so she can prepare everything. As she said many times later on, she got this. Until Felicity arrived, who is kind of an antagonist in this story. But not really. I mean, later on, we know how he owns the land. Which got me curious, as Daisy and Timber's campaigns started this camp, and was there from generation to generation. So how did it get into Friedrich's hands? It's simple. The answer is, it didn't. They probably borrowed some money from him to renovate the camp, but got behind in payment. This is why he said that this land is his now. But I think he had this as one of the conditions of him lending money, that if they can pay that in time, the camp becomes his own. This is why he didn't build a spa here yet. He would do that at the first second. And even though he's portrayed as a villain here, I have to tell that he's not a bad guy. He actually gave extra time to Daisy to collect the money she owes. And even if he couldn't, yeah, he could say no, just no, it's mine now, I don't give you any time. He's a rich businessman who just wants to see profit in every investment. So I guess there has been quite the interest on his landed money, but to reinforce what I said, he gave us a time and checked back from time to time if they can pay already. Whichever result he got the longest straw, because he got either paid or got the land to build a spa. And one more thing that is now a confirmation of the rejection of one of the theories. Vinyl is definitely not mute. She is having a nice chat with Fluttershy in the background. So whoever thought she can speak, here's the punch in your faces. She just chose not to speak. But back to the main character here, Twilight. She actually thinks every magic is bad, and it's all happening because of her. And I guess she would have tried to use magic if Kinch, Principal Kinch didn't insist on it. She's scared of it now. And she is scared to lose control. And if she infects others, as she called it, they might become demons as well. But as Twilight says, everything that has a bad side can have a good side on it. It's just how you look at it. And yes, I would do the same. If somebody could use the force near me, I would try it. Come on, Glassovota, come here. I mean, there is no one who saw Dragon Ball and didn't try to unleash Kamehameha at least once. But about the infected powers, Fluttershy is a Disney princess. AJ is Wonder Woman, Rainbow Dash is the Flash, Pinky has an exploding personality, Reality has the most useful one, and Sunset became the best counselor. I mean, Holland is now confirmed to be Harmony. We'll be speaking about this in a later, but that's when I don't forget. We have to talk about the Grandfather story first, that started it all. First of all, this time I realized that Timber and Daisy are brother and sister. Yes, I know they said it in the beginning, but still, this is when I realized it. Secondly, when he said that the branch has crashed through the cabin roof, I can discount that Wilhelm scream, but that was not a branch. That was a whole tree. And I wouldn't have minded if Gaia was the villain at all. Would make more sense seeing that we are in the Everfree Forest. This actually makes me think that the Everfree and Everfree are connected. True here as well, as the Everfree is the only place in the Pony world that acts as wild as in our world, or as in anywhere outside of Equestria. But again, I really had fun of the. I was really a fan of the effects of the dream sequence later on. We still couldn't be sure if it was just a normal nightmare created by Twilight's thoughts, or Midnight is actually still there, controlling her dreams. Having split personality can be really scary, and even more if the second personality is the complete opposite of yourself. And after Twilight Mom being one night, I'm not surprised that Sunset wakes up in a defensive stance. Or maybe she just saw too much karate movies. But yes, the main problem of this movie is not the evil magical being which should be neutral as Gaia, the Earth Spirit. It should be just defending its territory, but the evil magical being that lives inside Twilight and steals Luna's song. Yes, the second part of it has the exact same rhythm and notes as Luna's future, but it still has the same chilly effect. Spiced with some powerful third and fourth part of this solo. Even if it started big, this song is one of my favorites now. And I hope you all liked the new font I was using in the reaction, because this is much easier to read, in my opinion. But let's jump forward and speak about another controversy that happened in the movie that we have to talk about in greater detail, is the element of harmony. The seven elements. Yes, it is confirmed to be the element, and Sunset has one as well. Some might think that it is just a coincidence because this word is different, but how different indeed? We should discuss what's the difference here. For once, we thought that everything has a counterpart, which we confirmed by having Saitai. But that gives us greater problem. Where is human Sunset? I mean, there has to be one, or has to be one? Here comes my theory. Nothing easily proven, but I think Sunset actually always meant to be human, and her counterpart is Starlight. Both of them are part of the main seven. Both of them were somewhat evil, and when you start to see the first stars appearing on the sky at sunset, indeed. I consider having seven elements here being not an inconsistency, but Starlight actually getting an element as well in the other world, maybe in the seventh season. After all, she was not called by the map until now. Again, sorry if I'm wrong, this is just what I think. And the rest of the movie is really just a good throwback for the older movies, like Bonbon and Lyra wearing the bottom half of their bird costume, or Flash getting consoled by Derpy after other piece understand rejection. But I have to say, I had to listen to the villain song over and over to consider if the lyrics was standing forever free or standing for ever free. It was definitely a nice play on word placements. And I'm amazed that Snip and Stills recognize Daisy. They are so stupid that it is almost smart. But remember what I said about the costumes in the blind direction, mainly Twilight? Well, now I got it. Twilight never actually uses sunglasses whenever he changes forms. She has them in demon and superhero form as well, transforming the magic aura or pink googles. Without them, she wouldn't really see much, would she? These costumes are definitely much better than the ones they have in the Ponyverse, and I'm most amazed at Sunset's Sun Emperor outfit and Rarity's female Sub-Zero. It is quite strange to see their wings being crystallized though, and that is definitely not used butterfly. Speaking about wings, Sunset doesn't have them, so princess status denied. Even though she had one in the last movie. And lastly, before the outro part, we have to speak about the fundraiser concert, where Applejack is actually wearing really frilly clothes while not being bothered by them, and Trixie is being stolen from the title of the show's toppiest. Again, I am not against Twilight and Timber's relationship. Timber did a lot to reach at this point. They have a common interest, and he also asked her on dates later on. So even though I thought he was a bad guy who wanted to sell this camp. Which was really well paid. Tons of events. He fits was quite high. I mean, I'm sure there will be a lot of people who will hate him just as much as they did with Flash. But everyone can have their own opinions. Can they? Yep, they can. Now about the biggest problem, the outro. First of all, where is the statue? I know that Midnight Sparkle destroyed it, but when the quiet time at Twilight, it was whole again, which we know it happened as Sunset asked her about that incident, if she remembers. So, the portal got destroyed again and is leaking magic through Equestria. And if it didn't happen from this side, the only magic can destroy an open portal, we know that. Then something must have happened on the Equestrian side of it. And this leakage is also prepares for next Bumi. We are not left without the promise of Equestria 5, guys and girls. But again, my thoughts about the movie, it was absolutely fabulous, darlings. Just kidding, even though I wasted more than 10 hours of editing it. Yes, you had it right. It's still my favorite one of the four. And if you have anything to add that I might have missed, there are a lot of slight things I didn't speak about, or to think otherwise, you are free to discuss at the comment section. I read all the comments and answer them if they are meant to be answered. Tomorrow I'm gonna work, but probably record some episodes of Ruby, maybe one of the specials too. Time will decide, but thank you for being here through this long review. I hope you liked it and see you next time. Bye.